friends, I'm Miss Unger, and today we are going to be doing some really fun and fascinating learning about light and sound. Sure, you see examples of light and sound all around you every day, but I think you are going to be amazed at the ways light and sound impact our world. You'll learn how sound waves reach your ears and how your eyes process light. You'll even learn how light and sound waves travel through different objects. You'll learn how people use sunlight and shadows to tell time, before the creation of clocks. We'll investigate different ways that light and sound create energy, and we'll do some really cool experiments by building circuits to explore how electrical current travels. We'll explore ways in which light and sound are used to create art. And we'll look back through history at the ways people used light and sound in order to communicate. Throughout all of these activities, you'll be reading, writing, thinking, questioning, designing, building, but most importantly, you'll be having fun. So let's get started. To do all of these activities, you're going to need to learn about the properties of light and sound. The properties of sound include how loud it is, how fast it travels, and its pitch. Pitch is the quality that lets us know if a sound is higher or lower. We'll also learn about sound as a form of energy and how that energy travels. Here's what I mean by sound energy. Sound is a type of energy made by vibrations. Sound waves are formed when a vibrating object causes a solid, liquid, or gas to vibrate too. And remember, because air is a gas, sound waves travel through the air as well. Many musical instruments make sounds when their strings are plucked. An instrument could be as basic as a cardboard box and a rubber band, or a guitar, or even the stringed instruments in an orchestra. As you investigate sound energy in this lesson, you'll get to test your ideas by designing a musical instrument of your own. We'll also learn about the properties of light. The three main properties are the speed in which it travels, its color, and the way light reflects. You'll also learn about bioluminescence, which is a big word that means a creature that can create and emit light. This is a superpower that some marine animals and insects have. You'll also learn about light as a source of energy and all the ways that this energy is used in our everyday lives. Humans use light energy from the sun too. In fact, light energy is how we power space stations and satellites. We also produce light energy using tools such as candles, lanterns, flashlights, and light bulbs. And here's a fun fact. Light energy is the only form of energy visible to the human eye. We cannot see sound waves, but we can see light waves. And you're going to get to conduct experiments with light, too, just like you did with sound. You can even experiment with solar energy yourself by creating your own solar oven. Use light energy to cook some of your favorite snacks, like s'mores. You can make a solar oven using a cardboard box, black paper, tin foil, and plastic wrap. This solar oven uses light and heat emitted from the sun, and you'll determine how to use your materials to reflect the sunlight and trap the heat in order to cook your food. Now that is what I call a delicious discovery. All these activities will require you to use the same processes used by scientists. You'll make observations, form hypotheses, test your ideas, and communicate your findings. All the while, you'll be surrounded by exciting activities using light and sound. And the coolest thing is, you'll be using two of the most common and important tools that a scientist has, your eyes and your ears. So have fun!
To download the free lesson plans to be used with this program, visit us online at wqed.org/SOS. To request a hard copy of the lesson plans, please contact your local school district. Funding for this program is provided by the Pennsylvania Department of Education for Learning at Home.